Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I'm excited to be sharing some really quick and easy Halloween costume ideas. So let me know in the comments section which of these costumes is your favorite, and also comment down below what you're planning on dressing up as, and then we can kind of share ideas with each other in case anybody else still needs a costume. Make sure to like and subscribe, click that notification bell, all the usual things, and let's get started. The first Halloween costume is the red light, green light doll from the show Squid Game. This costume can easily be recreated without any bangs if that is something you don't have or don't want to worry about finding. But once those are clipped in, I'm going to continue my part down the back of my head to divide my hair into two equal sections. So starting with the hair on the left side, I'm going to combine all of the hair together and then tie it off using a clear elastic band. And the doll has really short pigtails. I'm going to only pull the hair partway through on the last wrap of the elastic to form a small loop. And then I'm going to take the ends of the hair and wrap these around the elastic band a couple times. Then I'm just going to tuck the ends back through the elastic underneath the bun to hold them in place. And this will kind of mimic the size and shape of her little pigtails. So now I'm going to combine the hair from the right side of my head and repeat the same steps again, creating another little pigtail bun. So I'm going to wrap an elastic band over the hair, and then only pull the hair partway through on the last wrap of the elastic to create the little bun. And then so the rest of my hair isn't sticking out from the elastic, I'm going to take these and wrap them around the elastic band, and then tuck the ends underneath the bun around the elastic to help hold them in place. And then as a last step, I'm going to take two little purple hair bands and wrap them over the buns in order to finish off this costume. The next three hairstyles I will be showing you are going to be more intense for the hair. Amos Professional has reached out to me to relieve the stresses my hair takes whenever I make these hairstyle videos. Made for professional hairstylists, the Amos Professional True Repair line is focused on both repairing the damages in hair cuticles as well as preventing moisture loss that causes damage to hair. So I will start with this routine to prep for the upcoming hairstyles. Beginning with the night cream, I like using this because it provides intensive nutrition care for damaged hair. My hair is continually being damaged from using heat tools and hairsprays. And when I am creating hairstyles that require hairsprays, I can apply the night cream beforehand to help protect the hair cuticles from the alcohol's drying properties. After cleansing my hair with the shampoo and treatment, I follow with the Hair BB Cream. It's formulated with a non-sticky light finish while helping to improve the health of my hair and its resiliency. This BB cream is formulated with extra adhesivity so that I can style my hair without the use of hairsprays affecting my pores and scalp. And then as a last step, I like to use the essential oil to help replenish the glow and softness in my hair. The next costume is cute little braided cat ears, and I'm going to divide off a section on the left side of the part at about the center of the top of my head. My section is about an inch thick. You can really make it larger or smaller depending on how big or little you want your ears to be. I'm going to braid this section of hair into a regular 3-strand braid, continuing the braid until it's about halfway down the section of hair. And then I'm going to take a bobby pin and just slide it over the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to repeat the same steps and create a second braid on the right side of my head. And I'm going to braid this into another regular 3-strand braid. So I'm crossing the side strands under the middle strand, and I'm going to continue the braid until it's about halfway down the section of hair again. And once the braid is long enough to create the cat ear, now I'm going to take one of the braids and bend it up so it forms the cat ear on the side of my head. And then I'm just going to take a bobby pin and slide this over the end of the braid so it pins it in place against my head. Then I'm going to take the other braid and repeat the same steps, pinning the braid against my head in the shape of the second cat ear. I'm also going to pinch the top of the braids so they point out a little bit. And then to finish off this costume, I used some black eyeliner to draw on a cat nose and some whiskers, and then a full black outfit. The third costume is Medusa. So for this look, I'm going to have my hair parted in the middle again. And then I'm going to divide off a section of hair from above my right ear. I'm going to braid this section into a regular 3-strand braid, continuing the braid down to the ends. Once the braid reaches near the ends, I'm going to go back over the braid and pull on the edges so it's a little wider. And I want to make it look a little disheveled and messy. And then I'm going to take a comb and gently backcomb the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. And now I'm going to repeat the same steps and create another 3-strand braid with a section of hair on the left side of my head. Then I'm going to pull on the edges of the braid to make it look wider and more disheveled.
And then I'm going to back comb the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to create one more braid on each side of my head, so I have two braids on both sides. And once all four braids are done, I'm going to take all of the braids and cross them in opposite directions over the top of my head, and I'm going to pin them all in place against the side of my head. So I'm lifting up the hair from the top of my head and then pinning the braids underneath. This will help hide the ends of the braids and make them look more like a crown style. And then to finish off the costume, I pinned some little snakes into the braids and then used my fingers to kind of tease up the ends of my hair. I wanted the hair to look kind of messy and more disheveled. And then to finish off my costume, I just wore a white sheet that I kind of pinned into a dress. For the next costume, I'm going to have my hair in a deep side part, and then I'm going to continue the part down the back of my head, and then I'm going to clip off the hair on the left side just to keep it separated. And now I'm going to split this right section into two more sections, and then I'm using a clear elastic band to tie off the bottom section of hair. And now I'm going to divide off a tiny piece of hair near the hairline to use this for my braid and split this into three smaller pieces. And since I'm creating a Dutch braid, I'm going to be crossing the side strands underneath the middle strand, alternating between the left and right side strands. And after the first stitch of the braid, I'm going to begin incorporating sections of hair from my head into the braid, so all of this hair that I left out is brought into the braid. And I'm going to create the braid along this section of hair that I divided out. So the braid will trail along the side of my head and then angle downwards towards the nape of my neck. And then once the braid reaches the nape of my neck, I'm going to take a bobby pin and slide it over the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. And once that braid is done, and repeat the same steps as before and create a second Dutch braid with this section of hair. I'm going to cross the side strands under the middle strand again to create a Dutch style braid. And I'm also going to be incorporating sections of hair into the braid, so all of the hair that I divided out for this section will be brought into the braid. And I'm going to continue the braid along the hairline through this section of hair above my right ear until it reaches the nape of my neck. And then once I've brought in all of the hair, I'm going to take a section of hair from the left side of my head and tie it together with the two braids using a clear elastic band. So once that's tied off, I can add in my safety pins to create the skeleton bones effect. And I used different sized pins, spreading them out throughout the two braids. And once that was done, I applied the skeleton makeup. I like this look because it's more of an easy last minute idea, and you can really end up wearing whatever clothing you wanted if you only wanted to do the hair and makeup portion part of it.
Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed today's video. Let me know in the comment section which of these hairstyles was your favorite, or costumes, I guess. Comment down below what you're planning to dress up as well, and then that way we can kind of share ideas with each other in case anybody else still needs a costume. Make sure to like and subscribe, click that notification bell so you never miss any future videos, and I will see you next time.